Adventures on Broad, Books 7 through 9, written by Tao Wong, narrated by Eric Jason Martin. The Guild's Demands, Book 7 of The Adventures on Broad. Chapter 1. Daniel Chai? The voice caught the adventurer as he wandered down from the stairs, running a hand through still wet brown hair. The wooden railings of the worn medieval inn pressed on his hands, the wood helping to guide him down after a late night of revelry. A smile still lingered on Daniel's lips as he recalled the young lady he'd left behind in his bed, asleep after a night of vigorous exercise. He only wished he could remember her name. The broad-shouldered adventurer turned his head, spotting the speaker seated at his table and positioned to catch sight of those descending from the inn's second floor. He raised the battered wooden mug filled with weak ale in greeting to Daniel. "Will you join me?" Daniel frowned, a hand dropping down to his side where his enchanted mace hung. He had put on the mace automatically, even though he was still dressed in his civilian tunic and pants, which needed patching by the laundress after his most recent escapade in the dungeons of Silverstone. He kept meaning to pick up a few more pairs, but there was always something better to do. "Do I know you?" Daniel asked. "No, but I hope to change that with this breakfast," the stranger said. Peering closer, Daniel took note of the finer weave of his clothes, the lack of fraying along the edges, the pair of rings with runic inscriptions on them, and the top of the bejeweled dagger that poked above the table from the stranger's belt. It all spoke of an individual with funds to burn, entirely unlike Daniel himself and his friends. It wasn't as though they were hurting for money these days. As advanced adventurers, Daniel and his team earned decent coin delving the dungeons on the regular. But having lost both new members of their impromptu party, the remaining trio were under strength for dungeons that consisted of the city of Silverstone. Attempts at finding new party members had thus far been less than successful, as most independent adventurers of quality sought to join the various guilds that made up the city. Of course, it left the trio to work the first few levels of each of the dungeons over and over again. In truth, the repetition was relaxing, as they quietly and steadily saved up for more powerful enchanted equipment to allow them to delve deeper. Daniel hesitated for a second before deciding to accept the invitation. While unusual, it was possible that the stranger was a client, someone seeking adventurers too cheap to use the official Adventurers Guild board. As Daniel took a seat, he did have to point out, "I have paid for my breakfast already. It comes with the room." "Yes, I know." The stranger grinned, pearlescent white teeth flashing underneath sky-blue eyes. The shock of pale yellow hair, almost transparent in its coloring and fineness, flopped in an artful wave across the stranger's face. "Which is why I paid for your accommodation." Daniel's eyes widened a little, since the night's accommodation was significantly more expensive than a single meal. It widened further as the stranger continued, "For the week." "You must really want to talk," Daniel said. "I do." Before the stranger could continue, he was interrupted by the innkeeper, who trumped out of the kitchen carrying a trencher of sausages, eggs, and blood pudding. He slapped the trencher down before Daniel, before turning away and stomping back into his kitchen. The stranger's eyes crinkled with humor as Daniel shrugged and withdrew his belt knife. "You don't mind, do you?" "Not at all. After all, I did pay for it," the man said, reminding Daniel not at all subtly. Ravenously, Daniel speared the sausage, slicing it up and popping it into his mouth, chewing upon it and enjoying the taste sweeping through his mouth. The innkeeper of the burnt table might be lacking in his early morning graces, but more than made up for it with his cooking ability. It was the primary reason Daniel stayed at this location, together with the deal he received from the innkeeper for helping with his injured foot. Even Daniel's gift, able to fix numerous issues with the physical body, could not heal the curse that the man was under. He could only relieve the pain the ex-adventurer felt on a regular basis. Before we go any further, I should introduce myself. I am Matthias Gill of the Three Skills Guild, Matthias said. He paused, lifting expectant eyes to Daniel. He was not disappointed. Daniel stopped chewing for a few moments, before continuing to pop chunks of blood sausage into his mouth. The kitchen door swung open again, bringing the innkeeper with his mug of water. As he set the drink down, Matthias gestured for another mug almost immediately. The innkeeper snorted, but tromped back to the bar to pour another mug of ale. This late in the morning, it was no surprise there were no other guests in the inn. Those who stayed at the inn were generally adventurers like Daniel, and most would have left early to seek new quests or begin a delve. It was only because Daniel and his team had come back yesterday from a multi-day exploration outside the city, completing a well-paying but long process of overseeing the planting of crops, that he was even here. Today was a rest day, and Daniel had plans to visit the local hospices on his usual rounds. Somehow, he did not think that his plans were going to play out today. "And what would the Three Skills Guild want with me?" Daniel asked. The guild was one of the larger, most powerful associations in the Kingdom of Broad, though its power came mainly from the numerous nobles and their connections. Rumors abounded that they had close connections, maybe even a hold, on the current royalty. Most of those rumors also tied them to certain unsavory acts, though most of those were just that, rumors. They also had a few well-provisioned and well-equipped delving teams, but for the most part, it was just rich crafters, crafting, running merchant stalls, and providing information services were what the Three Skills Guild were best known for. Their name was a bit of a misnomer, for the guild had pivoted in its origins from a mercenary guild to its current status over 150 years ago. Many of the original members had acquired their noble lineage, giving them the strong connections they were rumored for. Still, the guild kept its name for the sake of tradition.
"Oh, simply with an offer," said Matthias. "We are desperate to build up proper adventuring teams, and you and yours fit the bill."
Daniel raised an eyebrow skeptically. "That's nice to hear, if a little improbable. We did well at the contests, but not that well."
"Well, the guild is pivoting its direction slightly, and we'll be looking for more advanced junior adventurers other than cherry-picking from the top," Matthias said.
As hard as Daniel scrutinized the man, he could not find the lie. However, he knew that what Matthias spoke of was, at best, stretching the truth. There was no way that the Three Skills was looking so far down the ladder to pick up new advanced adventurers like them. Maybe in a couple of years, once they cleared at least one advanced dungeon. Of course, Daniel was also skeptical, for he'd already turned down quite a few other invitations. All of them, at least in the more recent groups, had couched it in terms that did not focus upon his value to them as an adventurer, but as a healer. Healers continued to be a large deficit in the adventuring economy, with few individuals having either the skills or the spells to fill that role. While powerful, potions were limited in use due to both their relative rarity and potential toxicity. That left healers to cover the gap. However, traditional healers only advanced from the process of healing, the usage of their skills. Traveling into a dungeon was not only damaging to their overall progress, it was dangerous.
"Well, thank you for the offer," Daniel said. He gestured with one grease-stained hand pointing up toward the roof and added, "as well as the room."
"You haven't even heard my offer yet," Matthias said.
"I know, but I've heard a lot of others," Daniel said. I don't see how it'd be that different. Oh, but ours is, Matthias said. He dropped his voice as he leaned in to whisper, We will help keep your secret safe. Secret? About your gift. The blood drained from Daniel's face, giving the game away. Not that it mattered, for Matthias looked very confident.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.